What's up, YouTube? It's Clash Cory, and today I'm gonna tell you all the best and worst minis and heroes in Clash Mini. That's right, we got a tier list video for you all. A lot of people have been asking for this. Now we're gonna dive in a moment, but first, what makes me qualified to make this tier list? Well, first of all, just as with any tier list, it's based on opinion, and you should also take into account what you personally are good at and comfortable with and adjust it based on that. But as far as me personally, I've played almost 500 matches so far in Clash Mini, about a 75% win rate, including doing quests. So I think that's pretty good. Also about top 20 in the world right now. So playing a lot of really good players. So based on all that experience is how I'm making this tier list. But let me know your thoughts on my tiers down below. All right, getting into it. First off, the tiers, D through S. The D tier units, I recommend you do not use. Try not to use them. Really, the C tier units are usable, but not really good recommendation. The B tier units are all solid choices and you can't go wrong, but they're probably not gonna carry you unless the opponent's really messing up. The A tier units are really good and inconsistently can carry you throughout some matches. But the S tier units are basically overpowered and can be really, really good and reliable. All right, now let's start off with the heroes and rank them accordingly and then go into the minis. The worst hero in Clash Mini right now, it has to be the Barbarian King, and I really do not recommend you use him until at least level 10. This hero tier list could change dramatically once a lot of people have every hero at level 10, because you get that extra ability, and for some heroes like the Barbarian King, it can be really, really important. But otherwise, honestly, he takes too long for him to super, and it's just not as valuable as the other heroes. I don't necessarily think the Barbarian King is like trash, but just compared to the other heroes, he's not nearly as good. The next worst hero is Shield Maiden. Shield Maiden used to be the strongest hero, but she got nerfed, right? So now she's definitely still usable. I have her in B tier. I still think she's pretty solid, but she's just not nearly as consistent. There's a lot more ways to beat her now. You don't need to build your deck in order to beat Shield Maiden like you used to have. The next best hero, in my opinion, is actually the Archer Queen. She's really, really solid, honestly, right now. You do kind of need to get her to around level 7, level 8, and then she gets some better attack speed and she's getting her super off faster, but you pair her with some other backline units who can take advantage of her super and that extra attack speed, and you can melt enemies as long as you have one or two good frontline units. The next best hero is the Monk. In A tier, the Monk is a really solid unit right now. Now, some of you might feel underwhelmed by the Monk, but trust me, once you get him to level 8, he has 21 health. And with that health, not only can he deal really good damage with a stun, he can also survive and tank for the rest of your team. But another reason why the Monk is really good right now is he's a little bit of a counter to the best hero, which is the Countess. The Countess got some really solid buffs, last balance change, and honestly, the Countess is the most reliable and consistent hero right now. You can basically put the Countess as a frontline tank, and with that crazy fast attack speed, she'll lose the aggro of melee, she'll heal up, and then she'll be able to do that again and keep on cycling and healing, losing aggro, healing. Overall, she's just a menace. It feels like sometimes it takes some luck in order to stop her. Of course, a lot of it has to do with positioning, but the Countess is definitely the best hero right now. All right, now into the minis. The minis in D tier that I think you should not be using are as follows. Let's do the healing ones first, the Healing Ranger and the Battle Healer. Honestly, these are units that if they're good, they're probably a little bit broken, but the way these units work right now, they miss their heals so much. Well, you might say, Cory, just upgrade them and then they'll, you know, do their heals. You tell me I have to spend even more elixir just for them to even work as they're supposed to work? No. Honestly, these units just take too long, first of all, for the heal to even go off, and then they miss sometimes. And you're telling me I need to upgrade them just so it's slightly decent? That's not good enough. These units are not very good. Do not use them, in my opinion. Next up is the Barbarian. And the biggest problem with Barbarian is he is a unit that needs to stay alive for a long time in order for him to become strong, but he has relatively low health and he's a frontline unit, which means he's going to get targeted before a lot of other units and he's gonna take damage pretty fast. So overall, he just doesn't have enough health in his kit for him to become good. The next and last unit in the D tier is actually the Mega Knight. And this one might surprise a little people. It's a little bit hard to rank a 4-cost unit down to the D tier, but I really recommend you not use this unit. For one, his damage is not high enough. For two, he's supposed to be a frontline unit that stuns other frontline units, but it takes him so long to get his super. And then you're telling me all of his upgrades, well, the first two upgrades buff his super, but it still takes a crazy long time in order for the super to activate. I mean, overall, he just doesn't provide really that much value for the cost that he's getting. There's another unit on this list which costs less elixir, which does some of the exact same things that Mega Knight does and is way better at it. All right, now into the C tier. I think all these units are usable, but maybe inconsistent, and they might need very specific team compositions. The Lumberjack is a very interesting unit. If you have the third star available for Lumberjack, where when you upgrade him at the start of the battle, he tosses a rage potion, in that scenario, it's possible the Lumberjack could be pretty good. But honestly, otherwise the Lumberjack is really not that good and I don't recommend you use him. And next in the C tier is the Dark Goblin. And similarly, if you have the stun ability, that's definitely the best one with Dark Goblin. But honestly, with the Countess being really strong and just with other units that can target the backline, the Dark Goblin just tends to die too quickly before he can really get going. And that's when he's good, is when he really gets going. But it's just way too inconsistent for him to be good. Next in the C tier is the Valkyrie. And honestly, the Valkyrie has the potential to be one of the best units in Clash Mini. I'm being serious. If you get the Valkyrie to 2-star upgrades, get those first two upgrades, or even the 3rd-star upgrade, she is insane. She does 2 damage per hit in AoE, and once, you know, later in the battle, she'll have crazy fast attack speed. Whenever she gets a kill, she heals up a lot of health. She becomes an unstoppable warrior. But the problem is getting her to that point. Honestly, the Valkyrie is kind of not very good in the first 2 rounds, and you need a unit to be good and usable in the first 2 rounds in order to consistently win matches. And the Valkyrie is just not a good unit in the first 2 rounds. There's not enough units. She needs those star upgrades to become a good unit, and it's just way too much of an investment in her for it to be viable. The one thing I'll say is maybe with a level 10 Barbarian King, could there be some possibility for the Valkyrie to have some time to shine? Now, next in this list is the Knight. And honestly, the Knight is not a bad unit. For 2 elixir, it's not a horrible choice. But the reason he's in C tier is he's just really not that great. Honestly, his super costs too much energy, so he's not able to get it as soon as you would want. He's really just a pretty underwhelming unit for a tank. He's just kind of meh. Like, he's there, he's in the fight. He might not be dying quickly, although if he gets unlucky, he definitely will, and he might not super. So, like, he's definitely usable, but yeah, just not that great. Now, the last unit in the C tier is actually the Mini P.E.K.K.A., and I feel like I could be overreacting a little bit placing him in the C tier. He might be more of a B tier unit, but the meta right now, and I mean that, the best tanks right now just kind of seem to negate the Mini P.E.K.K.A. When it was a Shield Maiden meta, Mini P.E.K.K.A. was a viable and good option because Mini P.E.K.K.A. does over 1 damage per attack, so was always able to do something to Shield Maiden. But now that it's not, the Mini P.E.K.K.A. just finds himself dying way too quickly before he's really able to do too much. He's really not a bad unit. I just feel like he's in an awkward role right now. All right, now into the B tier, and starting off with the Ice Wizard. And honestly, I was really close to putting the Ice Wizard into the C tier. I thought it for a long time. But honestly, I feel like a lot of people are sleeping on the viability of Ice Wizard. There are a lot of units where if you slow down their attack, it can cause you to win an early engagement and allow them, maybe their super won't go off. Or maybe that unit, like if you're slowing down the P.E.K.K.A., oh my gosh, it takes her so long to swing. When an Ice Wizard is targeting the P.E.K.K.A., it feels like she's not moving. Like, oh, it's just infuriating. But that just shows the viability of the Ice Wizard. You give the AoE upgrade, and all of a sudden she's slowing down multiple units, and she's definitely she. He is definitely viable. Next in the B tier is the Wizard. Now, the Wizard is actually really, really solid. And honestly, in the early game, he probably feels broken because people don't understand, you know, breaking their units apart, spreading them around. But if you do the Wizard with the Ignite upgrade, the second upgrade does a ton of damage. And as far as damage per elixir, Wizard might be your best bet as far as that's concerned. So he's definitely a good unit, just not like broken. The other upgrades are fine, but easy to deal with. Next in the B tier, and I feel like this might surprise some people, is the Magic Archer. The Magic Archer in the early game feels really, really strong because a lot of people don't know how to play around your positioning in order to not have the Magic Archer hit multiple people. But this is a learnable thing that you can fix and allow yourself to not get countered just through positioning. But one of the main reasons the Magic Archer is not higher on this list is honestly the upgrades for Magic Archer are kind of underwhelming. The third star upgrade is basically useless. The Dissipate ability can be pretty good, but you kind of need to be lucky slash predict very, very well what unit the Magic Archer is going to be hitting in order for that Dissipate to even be useful. The one extra damage per shot is not bad, but say compare that to the Archer who gets that upgrade for just 2 elixir compared to 4 elixir, sometimes it doesn't feel as good. And then not to mention there are some other units like the Miner and Countess which can easily negate the Magic Archer. Well, the Magic Archer is definitely viable and a solid unit, not amazing. Next in the B tier is the Spear Goblin. And the Spear Goblin is a definitely solid unit, especially if you're on any map that has a special tile like healing, like mirror, like Electro Valley. You can use the Spear Goblin and you're very confident that you're going to get a hit. Now, if you're on a normal map with no special tiles, in the early game when there's not many units, it might be hard to be super accurate with your Spear Goblin placement, but in that case, you just don't really spend much elixir on him. You're not upgrading him. Don't invest much in him, and it's not a big deal. But once you're able to make those predictions, you can then afford that small investment for a crazy boost to your early game. Now, the last unit in the B tier is the Archer. I was pretty close to moving the Archer to the A tier because for the elixir value you're getting, Archer is definitely good, but I just don't think Archer is quite amazing enough. Basically, you do that first star upgrade, so it targets 2 units, and then you can do the Clash ability, and even the Boast ability is actually quite good as well. The Archer is a very solid unit. Of course, there's just some other units that can target the backline quite easily, so the Archer might die relatively fast if you're not careful. Now into the A tier units, and what I think is maybe the worst unit in A tier, but still A tier, is the P.E.K.K.A. Big Mama P.E.K.K.A. Elixir value is quite high, in my opinion. You can do really well versus any single target tank and chomp them down. And seriously, the P.E.K.K.A. in my opinion is the second best tank in the game, not counting heroes. Like, obviously Shield Maiden is the best, right? But as far as minis, I think the P.E.K.K.A. is the second best tank right now. If you do the block Clash ability, can become an amazing tank who also is able to deal a lot of damage. Next in the A tier is the Bowler. Dude, the Bowler is so good, actually. I feel like people were sleeping on the Bowler when Clash Mini first came out, but if you think about it, the Bowler in a whole lane stuns people for 2 seconds and does 2 damage at the start of a battle to a whole row, to a whole column, not row, to a whole column. And seriously, especially if you're on any map that has a special tile or, you know, later in the game when there's more units, this can provide so much value. And that's the value just at the start of the game and not counting also upgrades. Not to mention the Bowler also does 2 damage per hit. So even without that, you know, if you miss that Clash ability, you can still have a useful unit on the board who's dealing some decent damage with decent health. Now the other unit in the A tier is the Skeleton Guard. And honestly, this is kind of reliant on having that third star upgrade. That third star upgrade might be one of the best upgrades in the game. If you get that Skeleton Guard to 2 or 3 stars with that last upgrade, ooh, that Skeleton Guard is really, really hard to kill. Seriously, an amazing unit. But even if you don't have that upgrade, I still think the Skeleton Guard is quite a solid unit. Now into the S tier, these units are relatively broken if played correctly. Starting off with the Miner. Now, some people might have the Miner as falling off because you can kind of learn how to counter the Miner, but you can counter the counter as well. So you can play a lot of mind games with the Miner. And honestly, if you realize that the opponent is putting a P.E.K.K.A. in the back of the map, guess what? You shouldn't upgrade your miner that much, but you can still cause a 4-cost unit to sit at the back of the map and be out of the fight the whole time because of how slow the P.E.K.K.A. is. But on the other hand, if your opponent is not doing very well to counter it, has a lot of backline units, maybe playing the Archer Queen, you can upgrade that miner a ton and counter them really easily. Next in the S tier is the Skeleton Giant, the best tank in the game right now, and also the most annoying mini in the game right now, probably, except for the other one on this list. But seriously, the Skeleton Giant just AoE damage and stun and tanking is just so good. And if you do the upgrade that gives you extra radius on the explosion and damage, it covers almost the whole map, and it just feels really, really overpowered and broken. And honestly, I hate facing this unit. And I'm gonna be honest, the Skeleton Giant is one of the main reasons the Mini P.E.K.K.A. is really low, because it just makes the Mini P.E.K.K.A. useless. And of course, the last unit in S tier is the Electro Wizard, just stunning 4 people plus 2 damage, and it only takes 4 hits, and Electro Wizard has really fast attack speed. So Electro Wizard, even without being in Electro Valley, is actually getting a solid amount of supers off per game. Like, just no question, the best unit right now. By the way, if you want my exact ranking, I rank units strongest from left and weaker on the right side. Well, let me know your thoughts on my tier list down below, and check out some great deck guides for Clash Mini right over there. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you later. Peace.